I know who runs this place.
Have you been here before?
No, but I was planning to come here before you and I met. This place belongs to a Turian scum named Ton Actus. It's a long story, but he's got something that belongs to me.
Well, what is it?
Family armor. It's been with us for over 5 generations. Turian military took it from my father's father after the war. Somehow this ass wound up with it. I want it back.
We'll get it back. Now let's move.
Right behind you. I can't believe my ancestors ever wore this piece of crap, but at least I've got it back.
I'm glad we could help you get it back.
I might just be starting to like you, Shepard.
Charging up.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
The general distress call from the Sacred Angel Medical Transport. Critical system failure. Losing power. An emergency landing. Argos. Communications failing. Life support. Emergency transponder. Won't last. Please hurry.
Careful, Shepard. I've got a bad feeling about this.
Thank you.
message coming in from the brass at Arcturus. Patching it through.
Normandy, Admiral Hackett here. We're getting reports of a marked increase in Geth activity in the Skillian Verge. Surveillance drones have identified Geth outposts on 4 different planets in the Armstrong cluster. We need someone to take them out.
I'm on it, Admiral.
Finding Saren is still your top priority, but you've got experience fighting the Geth. You're the logical choice to take out these outposts. We're transmitting all the locations of known Geth outposts in the Armstrong cluster to the Normandy now. Admiral Hackett out.
Yeah. night.
Target acquired.
outposts left to clear out? This should be fun.
Why did you want to be a CSEC officer in the first place?
That's a good question. There were several reasons, I guess.
Like what?
Probably the same as most officers. I wanted to fight injustice, wanted to help people. I guess my father had something to do with it, too. He was CSEC, one of the best. I grew up hearing about his accomplishments or seeing his picture on the vids after a big arrest. He's taking my resignation pretty hard.
That's tough, but you'd think he'd be impressed you're going after Saren.
My father's a CSEC man to the bone. Do things right or don't do them at all, he says. He thinks I'm being too rash, too impatient. He's worried I'll become just like Saren. He actually talked me out of becoming a Spectre when I was younger, for the same reasons.
You were asked to be a Spectre?
Well, I was targeted as a possible Spectre candidate, me and about 1,000 other Turian military recruits. I could have received special training, but my father didn't like it. He despises the Spectres. He hates the idea of someone having unlimited power with no accountability. He wouldn't like you, Commander. No offense.
I suppose I can understand his concern.
You can. But Saren's not going to play by our rules, CSEC's rules. If you want to nail Saren, you need to send someone who isn't restricted by policies and procedures.
Just because you can break the rules doesn't mean you should. I don't need to stoop to Saren's level to stop him. And neither do you, Garrus.
I see what you mean, but I'll think about it. Thanks, Commander.
So, we've got Saren on the run.
It won't be long now. Saren's good, but I'm better.
Good. He's rotten. To the core. I could tell as soon as I met him.
Why didn't you tell me this sooner?
I would have if I thought it was important.
I think I'd like to hear about it just the same.
This was a while ago. A bunch of mercs were bragging about a job out near the edges of the Terminus systems. They said it paid well, and the boss was never around to ride them. They said he was looking for more men, too. So I checked it out.
I didn't know Saren was openly recruiting mercs.
It wasn't that open, and he only showed his face once. We'd been raiding ships in the area for months when we took out this massive cargo freighter. Our biggest haul yet. I was on board checking bodies for valuables, looking for some extra credits. That's when I saw him.
What did Saren want with the ship?
I don't know what he wanted. He was just moving through the ship, watching. A couple of the mercs called him by name, but he never spoke to them. Never spoke to anyone. I had a really bad feeling about him. So I got the hell out. Didn't even wait to get paid.
That's the only time you saw him?
Yeah. Didn't even know who he was. Still wouldn't if I hadn't joined up with you. But my instincts were right. Every other merc on that mission turned up dead within a week. Every damn one.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Oh, hello, Shepard.
Are you okay?
I don't know. Your ship is amazing, and your crew's been really great to me, especially your chief engineer. But I just sort of feel out of place. The Normandy runs so smooth, it feels like we're not even moving. And the engines are so quiet. How do you sleep at night?
The silence wakes you up?
Back on the flotilla, the last thing you want to hear is silence. It means an engine's died or an air filter shut down. I guess you don't have to worry about that here. But old habits die hard. But it's more than just a silence. This ship feels so empty. It's like half the crew is missing. Back home, I couldn't wait to go on my pilgrimage. I couldn't wait to get away from the crowds. Now that I'm out here, I kind of miss them.
Sometimes we don't appreciate what we have until it's gone.
That's true. I'm starting to wonder if that's what the pilgrimage is really about. It's given me a whole new perspective on my people and our culture. You know, there's always a few who go on their pilgrimages and never return. I always assumed something bad happened to them, but maybe they just wanted a different life.
You do plan to return to the migrant fleet, right?
I could never abandon my people, Shepard. I will go back eventually, but we have to stop Saren first. Otherwise, I might not have a home to go back to.
I should go.
See you later.
Clear.
number two. Let's hit the next base.